link the accounts between them all? I would like to think that, right? Very weird. Do we know if Sunbreak has Switch / Steam cosplay, crossplay? The only way that Sunbreak would have crossplay is if you had a Capcom ID account that you logged into that would be able to enable that to happen, right? You need like a separate account system to make crossplay work in general. And Sunbreak doesn't seem to have that, as Rise does not have it. So the chance of there being crossplay or cross save is almost not going to happen because that's not built into Monster Hunter currently. Will it be for future games? Maybe, right? Maybe. Maybe you'll be able to play like the PlayStation version with the PC version, right? And you'll be able to... the only way that's going to happen, like, because a lot of people were asking about that. They're like, hey, why can't we have cross-save and cross-play for Monster Hunter Rise? Like, that was a big question that people had. The biggest reason is that they don't have, like, an account system built in. They have a way to put your... where to put your save data, you know? Between the different versions. So, if you don't have that, and your save data is sort of saved on a cloud with your account information for Monster Hunter games, then you know, there's a good chance that they could have cross-play, cross-save. But as of right now, I don't think that exists for Sunbreak or Rise. So in the same way that this makes me kind of happy, anyone with a Capcom ID linked to a Steam account can submit the entry. Those who do not make requirements for participants must have a Capcom ID, right? That sort of leads me to think that, oh, maybe this Capcom ID thing is going to be the future of crossplay. Maybe the Capcom ID thing might be the thing that makes the crossplay sort of function between all the versions of Street Fighter 6. Because that's the future we're heading to, right? We're heading to a future where games are coming out on everything now, and you should be able to play with everybody. No limitations to that shit. So, you know, and that's where that makes the most sense to me. It really depends. It does depend, right? We don't know. Cross save, they have to have the infrastructure to make it work, you know? They need to have, like, the way to get the same file between all the different versions. That doesn't require you putting it on a USB drive or something like that and transferring it. They need to have their own cloud system or something that has the save data that it can just go boink and pull the save and be like, oh, you're on the PC version, here's your save, you know? So, that's good, right? The fact that Sunbreak has a demo, which it usually does, a network demo, the fact that this has a network demo is practically confirmation that Street Fighter 6 is going to have a network demo. It's kind of funny that we have the most information on Street Fighter 6, and a release date, but there's barely anything about Resident Evil 4, and we actually have a release date for that. And there's also a network test for a game that we don't know when the hell is coming out next year. We have no idea when the hell this is even going to be coming out, but still, there is a network test. So I'm confident that Street Fighter 6 is going to have a network test. It's what you have to. But the question is, how long do you have to wait for that? Here's my prediction. Here is where I start making predictions of where this stuff is going. I feel the next big announcement that we're probably going to get for Street Fighter is most likely going to be Evo, right? It's going to be something around August. I think at Evo, they announce, like, a couple of characters. But I think at Evo, they also announce the network test. They'll also announce, like, the beta / alpha of when you can actually play Street Fighter 6. And it'll be, like, a cross-play alpha or something like that. That would make people lose their goddamn minds, right? Just absolutely, that's the best way to do it. So, I don't know if we'll have four characters, six characters, whatever, I don't know. But just allowing people to play the game from home and give it a shot and just experience what the heck it's like. Evo is the place to do that because that's where you have, like, your biggest audience that'll be really testing out Epcot stuff. You want to get their attention because they'll be the ones that'll be most interested and invested into seeing if it's good. And based on what I played, it'll probably make a lot of people very happy, you know? So that's my big prediction for Street Fighter 6. I don't think we're going to be seeing anything. If there is going to be, like, a network test announcement, that'll probably be at Evo. And Evo is early August, I believe. I think it's the first week of August. Is it rollback netcode? It's rollback netcode. It's new generation rollback netcode. Not the same as Street Fighter 5 or Marvel Infinite. Rollback netcode built from the ground up in RE Engine, and it is also crossplay between all versions. So, you're definitely gonna have to make an account for that, right? Save your character and stuff like that. So, generation. So the netcode that they used for previous Capcom fighting games is called Kagemusha. Kagemusha 1.0 was used in Street Fighter 5, it didn't work out great. And then Kagemusha 2.0 was severely improved in Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite and was a much better online experience than Street Fighter 5. But what they're doing is not that. They're not using that as the base because there was already issues with that old generation netcode. And they are essentially creating a new generation rollback netcode from the ground up for RE Engine because this game is not in the same engine as the previous Capcom fighter. That stuff was in that was in Unreal. So now they're making this, they're making Street Fighter 6 in the RE Engine, proprietary engine. And just maybe, right, just maybe, they'll actually come up with something a lot better because this is the stuff. Well, I like to think so. Capcom seems to genuinely really give a shit about the quality of life about Street Fighter 6. And there was a weird thing where I was asking the devs directly about the online, and they seemed very eager to answer questions about online stuff. And that's where I found out that the game is going to be crossplay between everything. So, yeah, it seemed like they were, like, ready for questions about, like, netcode and crossplay and how things are going to work. But they can't answer too much, but they seem like, yeah, ask us questions about the netcode, bro. But they kind of were given the impression. So, interesting, right? Very interesting. Do you have a video game some years ago about not made here? How is this different? The pandemic happened. This is why this is different. The pandemic took place, essentially forced a lot of the industry into a corner. And essentially brutalized several fighting games that did not get an opportunity to shine because their online was not good, and it was essentially the only option that people had. At that point, that was a make-it-or-break-it situation. Guilty Gear was forced into a corner, where even Guilty Gear had to put a rollback netcode into their games. That happened practically because of a huge demand and the pandemic. So, you know, there was a lot of... eventually, like, so many people saying so many things, and when so much of that happens, and the big word of mouth that happens as a result of it, as of right now, you have to realize that devs, especially post-pandemic, were essentially forced to put rollback into their games, because if it didn't have it, they would just get eviscerated. People would just be like, give it. So things changed, right? The industry essentially changed because of the pandemic. Right? If you release a fighting game and it doesn't have, like, rollback netcode at this point, or not just old-ass delay-based netcode, good luck, right? Good luck. I don't know what you're gonna get your audience who's gonna buy the game, and your casual audience will be there, but if you're talking about people that will be able to be excited about playing it, you know, online, instead of just playing it for the sake of playing it, you're gonna deal with a shitstorm. That's the way it is. If there's actually one good thing as a result of the pandemic for fighting games, it was the fact that they essentially forced the Japanese side of development to come up with solutions. Essentially forced them to work. So shit changed. Long story short, why does this not apply to the not being here situation that has been the case for a lot of stuff in Japan? Shit changed. And it might be pretty obvious that Street Fighter 6 is not being made for Japan. Pretty obvious that if you have, like, a hip-hop urban street game, that isn't exactly indicative of the Japanese market at all. Street Fighter 6 is absolutely being made for, like, a Western audience. So, they're trying to go big scope, right? They're trying to create something that is a worldwide thing, and this doesn't feel for one area. They're going outside the bubble, you know what I mean? Anyway, is there brand new RE4 stuff? Let's see if we can look that up. What do you think? An RE Dragon's job could be on the new one? I'll tell you right now, there is absolutely zero reason Capcom would want to pay royalty fees to use a version in any of their games. Why would you think Epic Games will spend 50% of all their budget? Why would they be doing that? All I'm telling you is that if there's big 3D games or almost any game that's going to be coming out from Capcom, this game, their engine is so versatile, there is zero reason to be using any other engine. Ferrari engine on a Switch, and I enjoyed that experience. Right? A Contractor game with insanely complex gameplay mechanics, ridiculous stuff that has to account for the biggest, bigger zones than even some spots in Monster Hunter World, and on Switch. And it actually ran at a relatively stable frame rate. It didn't run at 60, but that is hardware from like 2013. That's ancient shit in that system. It's not even that good. And it ran an RE engine at 30 FPS. I don't know what to say, man. Like, they essentially have a diamond in the rough with this engine, and guess what is costing them to produce games in this engine? Nothing. They essentially front-loaded the cost of development to make the engine, and now they've made how many games, and they haven't had to pay any money. It's honestly one of the reasons why Capcom is doing so good over the past few years. Their revenue is all going to them. Well, most of it's going to them. They're not having to pay licensing fees to Epic or anybody else's engine for doing so. So now they're essentially a giant, like, golden era. You know? You're not getting any Capcom games, anything but RE Engine anytime soon. Finally, no more going to be brand work? Well, I mean, in all honesty, RE Engine is just NT Framework 3.0. In several ways, right? But let's be honest, there's still a lot of things in that happened in the RE engine that essentially are the same issues as MT Framework as far as some texture quality and stuff like that. Like, there is definitely some issues there. But here's the thing, is that RE engine is amazing at lighting. Like, incredible at lighting. So you don't really notice those problems. But yeah, like, a lot of the same issues that were present with MT Framework are definitely there in the RE engine, which is kind of funny. Will RE engine help with fighting game input latency? I can tell you, based on me playing a fighting game in RE engine, because I did play Street Fighter 6, a lot of the monitors that were at that event had a lot of input delay, and I was a little worried. And then I hovered over to other monitors because it looked sharper on those ones, and I was like, oh, I think all the effects, the TV effects that add input latency are off on this one. And I hovered around those machines specifically, and yes, the input delay was very minor, very small. In fact, I would say arguably on the other TVs, like the cinema mode was on those TVs, and the input delay was like 7 to 10 frames. It was really bad. I was like, woo! I feel like I'm playing online on this shit. And then I went to another TV, and it was super smooth. Like, my game came out almost immediately. So it was pretty damn fast. So, yeah, once you played it on the at that event that I went to, it was very responsive. So I didn't feel like there was a crazy amount of input latency, at least early on. Yeah, what else is out there right now? Do we have any links to Big Resident Evil stuff? Yeah, Dragon's Dogma 2, whatever future games you were talking about for Capcom stuff in the future, that comes out on RE Engine, right? There's no way Dragon's Dogma 2, if it eventually is announced sometime next week, is not on RE Engine. There's absolutely no way. And it's Itsuno, right? Itsuno had one of the premier games on RE Engine. He did RE5 on that. He did RE5 on that. So there's no way. Like, their development team is already familiar with it. What did I say? Did I say RE5? I meant DMC5, yeah. I'm reading two different things on Twitter, and I'm reading the chat. You'd be shocked how difficult it is when you're reading a bunch of stuff, chat, and trying to create a cohesive thought process while also reading a bunch of shit at the exact same time. It's like riding a bike backwards, downhill, trying to drink a cup of water. Hold on a second. Dovahkiin put in 20 gift subs earlier and then 30 more. My God. Thank you very much, Dovahkiin, for the shit, man. That's super nice of you. Jeff is looking at like a weird presentation of RE8. Screenshots? Oh, there's some 4K. Okay, hold on a second. Let me go to the press site and see if I can find what's going on. I do have some screenshots for you guys. Give me a second. I'm going to select all of these. These are like 8 meg PSPs. I'm just going to download all of them. Third person in October. It's part of the big update that they're doing. And the new RE8 DLC is also in third person. So you get to play through the game a completely different way. So here we go. Here's the new screenshot of Resident Evil 8. There is the spooky, right? The house. Oh shit. Oh shit. Damn. Flashlight Leon? Oh shit. Dankest, like the road to the village is essentially the dankest looking place. You know what I love about this? It reminds me of Resident Evil 8 when you're on the way to what is it? House Villanueva or what is it? Whatever, the Bellanueva? I forget what the name of that house is, the Spooky Puppet House. And you're going through this crazy dank forest and it's super like a Menino, that's what it is. It's super spooky, right? That's what they're getting the village into. They're putting it into mega spooky puppets, which is very much down to that. It's gonna be a different tone, it's gonna be different than the original RE4, but I think all of us were sort of expecting, you know? Sort of expecting. It is because he was a noob in the first game in the same way that RE2 to RE4 had Leon, you know, turn into a superhero. That's what I want to see. I know he's not going to be a superhero in this game, but he definitely needs to have some combat prowess outside of just shooting the gun, you know? I don't want to see him rolling around on the floor John Woo style. I want to see Leon have some mechanics, right? That's all I want. I want mechanics. Leon to be imbued with Right? And that's why I'm kind of disappointed with what was shown with RE4, was that they essentially just showed off Leon's face. And I'm like, oh, come on, right? Oh, come on. It's just Leon's face. I want to see you shoot something! Sorry. That's why I'm a little disappointed with what they showed with RE4. Are we gonna finally see Ethan's face? I think so, right? Are they gonna be very clever about how they hide it? They might be very clever of how they hide Ethan's face, and that might have been a challenge for the devs that you only see like 1/10 of his face or something like that. I don't know. You just want one suplex? Something. Yeah, you see like the side of Ethan's face, like back here, but not like a straight face shot. We'll see. You technically already saw it in cutscene. Yeah, you see, Ethan has a face. You've technically already seen it. So, Monster Hunter Sunbreak demo officially is out tomorrow at 7 p.m. Pacific. So, I am going to have to find a way. You know what I want to do? We are playing RE games again, but you know what I want to do? I want to play through all of the, and we're actually starting from the beginning already because we are playing RE4. I want to play through all of the third-person RE games again, right? And maybe that includes Revelations and Revelations 2. Maybe that includes Resident Evil 4, Resident Evil 5, Resident Evil 6, Resident Evil 2 Remake, Resident Evil 3. Yeah, we should try to go through all of these before the game comes out next year, right? Try to get through all of them. And yeah, me and Steve should possibly team up again for Umbrella Corps? Oh, God. Me and Steve should possibly team up again for, like, RE5. Maybe do an RE5 randomizer or some shit. That would be fun. Make RE5, like, crazy. We'd have to do RE6 again, which would be very unfortunate, right? But, yeah, that'd be fun. That'd be very fun. Are you gonna play Dragon's Dogma? Here's the thing. If they officially announce, like, Dragon's Dogma 2 in an actual teaser or something like that, yes. We'll find some time to play through Dragon's Dogma 1 again. I have Dark Arisen on PC, obviously. So, yeah, we'll give it a shot. But in terms of, like, like, the older Resident Evils, like, the static camera angles, I don't think we need to go through those again, right? I think it would be nice to revisit all the third-person Resident Evil games, because now, I mean, obviously, third-person is a huge deal to Resident Evil again, because they're making all of Resident Evil 8 in third-person, its DLC is in third-person, Reverse is in third-person, and, Resident Evil 4 pioneered the entire genre for the most part. So, is there any part of RE6 I actually enjoyed? The beginning part of Leon's campaign is okay, right? The city and you're like above the gas station and you're kind of like, you know, holding out, that's okay. A lot of that stuff is fine. But anything else that happens when you get to, when you eventually go to China in that game, oh fuck, is it rough. Oh my god, like the game like takes a huge turn and it is like no good for every single character once they eventually take that like halfway through the campaign and they go across the world to the place that takes place in like the big Chinese city. It's